हेलो एंड वेलकम माय लिटिल चैम्प्स ऑफ सेकंड स्टैंडर्ड. दिस इज रोहन तरवानी, योर रोहन सर, एंड वेलकम टू ग्रामर लेक्चर. एंड आई वांट टू जस्ट टेल यू, यू नो, इन ब्रीफ दैट व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू डू टुडे. टुडे वी आर जस्ट गोइंग टू फर्स्ट रिवाइज व्हाट वी डिड इन यस्टरडेज लेक्चर, दैट इज एक्सरसाइज नंबर थ्री, एक्सरसाइज नंबर टू एंड थ्री इनफैक्ट. And then we are going to solve the remaining exercise, which is exercise number 4. And students, after solving that, today we are going to do one interesting thing. That is, I am going to just give the glimpse of chapter 1, 2 and 3 again. So that in case if you have missed out any of the lectures, you will just get to know the overall concept of what we did till the date. I hope that you all are going to stay tuned, stay connected in this video lecture, and are going to watch the video with a keen interest. So, let's start it. So, students, here what we started yesterday is chapter number 3. The name of the chapter is One and Many. This is what we did in yesterday. This is what we started in the yesterday's lecture. Correct? So, in this lesson, first of all, I explained you how to make the plural out of the singular word. Correct? Sometimes it is possible just by adding the S at the end of the word. Correct? So, as you can see here, if it is one girl, we say only a girl. If more than one, we say girls. So, the difference is only S. This is very basic, first of all. That's why it is kept in the warm-up exercise, correct? So, similarly, chair becomes chairs. Only the difference is we added S at the end of the word, correct? So, this is how the basically, we make plural out of the singular. But the concept is not, limited till here. There are many different ways to make the plural out of singular. But before that, we just went through the warm-up exercise where we solved this picture exercise. Correct. If in the picture we can see the one photo of something, we have to write one in the blank. And if many, we have to write many. We did with this with the same thing with the car. Correct. In this picture, there are three cars. So not one, but more than one, correct? So we are supposed to write many, correct? In all the blanks, the same thing was there. In this picture, I highlighted the dog. So we are supposed to write one because there is only one dog seen in the picture. Similarly with this boat, we wrote here one, correct? Because only one boat was there. And then in the homework, I gave you to solve the remaining one, these three pictures. Let me solve it for you, if you have any doubt. See, students, in this picture, you can see not only one, but many birds are there. See, if we count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes, so 6 birds are there. So, we cannot write one in this. We have to write many, right? Because many birds are there. So, similarly here, in this picture, 3 candles are there, correct? So not one, but many are there. So we have to write many in this blank. So if you have written many here and as well as here in this bird's photo, you are absolutely right. And at the end, the picture of this diary or book, you can say, only one. Yes, can you say any other? No, only one is there. So you have to write one in the blank. This is what I gave you in the homework and now I solved. Furthermore, we discussed this definition in the yellow box. What is this definition? When there is one person, animal, place or thing, we say they are in singular. Correct, they are single, one. So we call it singular. But when there is more than one person, animal, place or thing, we say they are in plural, correct? Because they are many, not one. We cannot call it as a single, correct? So this is what we went through yesterday. And then further we solved the first exercise. Yes, what was the trick, what was the hint to solve the first exercise? It was very simple. We need to just form plural by adding s, correct, at the end of the word. So the table became tables, flower became flowers, and we solved the exercise thoroughly, correct. I did not leave any answer for you. I solved it for you, the full exercise. I solved it for you, correct. And then moving on, students, here what did we do? We saw that how the plural was formed by adding es at the end of the word. Yes, for example, fox became foxes by just adding the es. The same thing with glass became glasses just by adding es. Bus became buses just by adding es, and so on. So in the warm-up exercise, we saw how can we make the plural by just adding s. But here we saw how to make the plural by adding es, correct. And then here is a kind of hint for you. Yes, as you can see the highlighted part, if any word ends with x, double s, ch, s, sh, and o, only then you have to add es at the end of that word. This I don't have any magic. You have to remember this clue. Yes, this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 endings you have to remember anyhow. Correct? You need to remember that if these 6 endings are there, if either of these 6 endings are there, you need to add es in case if you want to form plural of any word. And then we solved exercise number 2, in which you need to write the plural forms by this method. Okay, so torch became torches by adding es. Similarly, class became classes by adding es. Mango became mangoes, again same by adding es. Then what do we have to do with bench? How can we make the plural of the word bench, students? Yes, those who answered by adding es, you are absolutely right. You just need to add es as you did with the remaining words. Yes, hero become heroes. Yes, if only one hero is there in the photo, you say this is my favorite hero. But if you have more than one favorites, what do you say? These are my favorite heroes. Correct. For example, if you say my dad and one hero from the movie, so there are two heroes, correct? So we need to just add es at the end of the word hero to make it plural. Okay, and then we also solved this. How to make the plural form of the word by adding, or you can say by just replacing ies. Yes, if the word ends with y, see, the word baby ends with y. So in that case, you need to replace the alphabet y with three alphabets ies. So the word baby became babies, correct, by replacing y with ies. Similarly, the candy, word candy, students, if you can see on your screens, the word candy ends with the alphabet y. What do we have to do? Simply, again, we need to change, we need to replace the alphabet y with ies. So the candy word will become candies, correct? If there is one candy, we say it is one candy. But if you can see in this photo, not one, but many candies are there, correct? So we cannot say candy. We have to write the plural form of that word. We need to use the plural form of that word, candies, right? So the written instruction is here. Second time, I want you to read along with me. If a singular noun ends with y and the letter before it is a consonant, we change the y to ies to form its plural. Correct? You have two criteria. It should end with Y and the letter before that should be consonant. Now see, the word candy, if you can see students, it ends with a Y. Correct? Also, the letter before is consonant. See, D is consonant. Do you remember consonant and vowels, student? Yes. Vowel is A, E, I, O, U. These five are the vowels and the consonant are the remaining alphabets from A to Z. Correct? So, D is a consonant. So, we need to change Y. We need to replace Y with I, E, S. This is what the definition suggests us. Furthermore, we discussed the exercise number 3 in which you had to write the plural form. How we made the plural form from these words? We simply replaced the Y with IES. So students, the word CITY, city, here you need to replace alphabet Y. So CIT will remain as it is. And we need to replace Y with IES. So the word will be CITIES. Correct. So the answer will be CITIES. This is how we change the word. Same with pony. If we replace Y, it becomes PONIES. Ponies. Same with lilies. It is a flower. So LILIES instead of this alphabet Y. And butterfly. So you just have to replace Y with IES. So the spelling will be like BUTTERFLIES. Correct? So butterflies. The same way, party. So you need to replace Y with IES. So the spelling will be PARTIES. Parties. Okay, so it is very easy, student. See, many of them I have already solved for you. Correct. This I solved it again so that in case if you have any doubt while doing homework, see, I don't know if you have done or not. I have already sent you the PDF format file of the grammar textbook in your WhatsApp groups. Correct. So it is very much necessary for you to practice, because unless you practice, you won't be able to solve it on your own. Correct. I insist you to solve the grammar exercises on your own. Only then will you be able to solve it on your own, because I don't want you to copy it just from my video lectures. That is why I'm not going to write the answers henceforth. I'm just going to suggest you how to do. I'm just going to show you the path. Okay, now the time is to solve exercise 4. Let us see what is the heading of exercise 4. Choose the correct options to fill in the blanks. You need to choose the correct option from the blanks and then you need to write that correct option in the blanks. I'm just going to highlight the answers, as I said, because if I'll write the answers, what do? You just copy down the content, which is not good for you at all. So let us start exercise 4. I will just read the answer for you and then we'll gradually solve the blanks. The first question is, there were new desks on the tree. Now were, the word were is here. Correct. Were is never used for singular unless it is a personal pronoun I. Sometimes you can use I were if I were the prime minister, but other than that, were is never used for singular. So obviously fruit is incorrect answer. So the correct answer is fruits. So you have to write here fruits, because fruits is the correct answer. So the sentence will be like, there were new fruits on the tree. Correct? This will be the correct option. Similarly, let us solve the sentence B. The question is, The desks are clean. Again, my dear students, here in this blank, the word are is used. Again, are is never used for the singular word, for the singular noun. No, it is always used for the plural. So here, you just need to select the correct plural form of the word, whether it is first one or whether it is this second one. How can you make the dish plural word? So simply you need to add es at the end of the word, correct? Dish is. This is the correct option for the blanks. Yes, just remember es. You just don't have to add s, you have to add es at the end of dish. So it will become dishes, the plural of the word dish. So the answer will be like, the dishes are clean. That will be the correct answer for the blank B. Okay, similarly, let us solve C, sentence C, blank C. So my dear students, let me read the question first of all. And yes, I will wait 2 or 3 seconds for you to shout the answer loudly at your homes. Yes, even though if your parents scold you, tell them that we are studying and we are shouting something which is really useful. Though I will not be able to listen to you, because by the time this video is uploaded, I will be making another video for you. Anyways, jokes apart, you have to shout the answers which you feel. So let me read the question first of all. In summer, the desks are long. Yes, students, two options are given to you, one and two. Two options are given to you. Both are the plural, but one is correct, one is, the second one is incorrect. Which one is incorrect? This one or this one? What will be the correct spelling? D-A-Y-S or D-A-Y-E-S? What could be the correct spelling? Yes? If you see, my students, here Y should be replaced with I-E-S, correct? But the rule was, there should be consonant before the ending Y. But here, A, if you can see, before the alphabet Y, alphabet A is there, which is not consonant. Again, A is a vowel, correct? A-E-I-O-U. So, this is the correct option. If you have selected first option, you are very much right. Congratulations. So, the sentence will be like, in the summer, days are long. The days are long in the summer, correct? Now, the summer season is going to go, going to vanish. Let us solve the D sentence in the same way. The desk ran fast. Again, two options are given and both are in the plural form. The one is correct, another is incorrect. Which one is correct? You have to select that. Okay, so this is very easy. This one is like, in the two options, the one is like very much incorrect. You can easily recognize. So I'll keep this for you in homework. Again, let us solve sentence E. Let me first read the question for you all people. So here, how many desks have you visited? Okay, options are countries and countries. The pronunciation is same, but there is the mistake in one of the options. Which one is that? Is it this one or this one? Correct. You need to recognize it correctly. So let me tell you, my dear students, that here the main word is country, only till Y, correct? So it should end with S if you want to make it plural, or it should end with IES. So first you need to see it ends with Y. So and the word before, the alphabet before the Y is R, it is consonant. So it has to be replaced with IES according to the rule. Yes, the rules are on the tip of my tongue because I have practiced it a lot, a tons of time. So, like I said, grammar is the subject of practicing and not mugging up the answers. Yes, it is not in English so that you will remember the answers. You have to practically think about it. So, the correct option is this one, countries, IES. So, the answer will be like, how many countries have you visited? Correct. Similarly, let us solve some interesting blank rather than just solving it the easy ones. Which one should be the... Okay, so here, sentence J. Now, my dear students, let me read the question first, as I do always. He visited many desk. Again, two options, both are in plural form. One is correct, the another is incorrect. You have to select the correct option here. CITYES or CITIES. The core word, the base word is CITY, city. And then you have to make the plural of that word. So again, you have to think. Again, the word ends with Y. And the word before, the alphabet before is T. That is again consonant. So if the word ends with the alphabet Y, and if the word before is consonant, you have to replace the alphabet Y with IES. So obviously this one is the correct option. CITIES. We even solved this word. We even wrote the plural of this word in the before exercises, I remember. So the sentence will be like, he visited many CITIES cities. So students, congratulations. With this we have totally completed chapter number 3 in the grammar. Now as per our agenda, we have to again solve the... we have to just take the glimpse of all the chapters for you. So here I am going to bring chapter number 1 again in front of your TV screens, in front of your screens. And so that I can just give you the glimpse what have we done till the date. First of all, we solved this chapter number 1, nouns. Correct? In which first we got to know the meaning of the word noun. The meaning of the word noun was naming words, means the name of something. Correct? But the picture was not yet finished. It was not the end yet. Further, we solved first exercise in which you had to tag the pictures. This was the chair, this was an apple, flower, tree, correct? You had to choose the word from the box. This is the exercise continued. You again have to tag the pictures. An owl, duck, yes? We solved it very well. And then we went on to the definition of common nouns. Yes? Let me again repeat it for you as we are taking the glimpse. These nouns tells us about the name of the any person. See, any person, but not the particular person. And I showed you these examples and then we solved like the boy. Here, boy means it could be Rohan, it could be Ibrahim, it could be Saeed, it could be Ali, it could be Parvez, etc., etc. These all are the name of boys. Correct. So the boy is not limited. Boy can be anyone, any male, we can call them as a boy, correct? So it is not special name given, it is name given to any commonly, like the there might be the boys in your class and the girls in your class, correct? So boy is a commonly word used for every boy, yes? So it can be called out to the any person, so it is a common noun. Similarly, a book. Now it could be your English book, social book, grammar book, ENV book, etc., etc., etc. So book is even commonly used word for all the books, correct? It is not a special name given to any book. So again, it is a common noun. So they do not refer to any particular person, place, animal or thing. See, not to particular, to general, to common. And after going through it, we then discussed the exercise 3 where you had to recognize that each particular noun falls in which particular column and category. Yes, for example, if we say farm is the place where the farmers work and cultivates the crops. So it is a place. It is neither it is a people nor animal nor thing. It is a place. So you have to write farm in this column. So if you have forgotten how to solve it. Yes. And then again park. If you can see here the word park, correct? Park is like again the place where you go to play, where the kids especially go to play, where you go for the morning walk, correct? And then sister. Now sister is animal? No. Though you fight with your sister and call them animal, but they are originally it falls in the category of people. So this is how we solved the third exercise. And then we moved on to the proper noun with the pictures of examples. If you can see that the sentence is here, we go to the Central High School. Now, not only school, but the special name is given to school, that is Central High School. So if particular name is given, again, if you can see in this picture, cat. Now cat is common noun, but the name is given, see. This is my cat, Spice. So Spice is special name given to this cat. So if it is particular name, special name given, then it is a proper noun. Let us again read the definition. So if you have left out in any way, you will be able to cope up with us. The highlighted nouns are names of a special boy, girl, animal or a place. These nouns are called proper nouns. Proper noun always begins with capital letter. My dear students, this is where many of you make the mistakes in the sentences. Yes, if you can see the highlighted words here in the examples, they all begin with the capital letter. Compulsorily, it is very much mandatory. If it is a proper noun, you have to start that with the capital letter. See, Agra, it is a place, so A starts with capital. A is capital, correct? So after that, what did we do? We solved the exercises related to the proper noun, and this was very important note in the orange box, which I already explained you, that be it the name of the sea, rivers, festivals, weeks, all are considered as a proper noun. It has to be the special name. And then furthermore, we solved exercise 5, where you had to choose the correct words and fill in the blanks, right? And then in the chapter of articles, what did we do? We just understood first that what is vowel, what is consonant. Again, I repeat, vowel means A, E, I, O, U, and consonant means the remaining alphabets other than A, E, I, O, U in A to Z. And then if the word starts with vowel, we have to put N. If not, we have to put A. For example, orange starts with O, which is vowel. Then we have to put A, N in the blank. Okay. Similarly, ox starts with O, which is vowel. Then we have to put N. And the rest, where the consonant is there, for suppose shoes starts with the alphabet S, which is consonant. So we have to put alphabet A only. Correct? And then we discussed how to use the article in the blanks, and then we solved the exercise 3 and 4 using the article the, which was not there in exercise 1 and 2. And then you all know we ended up with the chapter number 3, one and many, which is singular and plural. So I hope students you have watched this video carefully, where I have solved chapter 3 all over, and then all over we started with exercise 1 and 2, the glimpse we saw, which is overview. And now I hope you enjoyed today's lecture, and I hope that you are going to solve the exercises for which I have already given you the PDF file in your WhatsApp groups. Enjoy your day, enjoy solving the exercises, stay safe, stay home. My dear students, goodbye.